or into your Blessed Mother, into our Blessed Mother, to say, please help me with this. So, as people can be, you know, sometimes to face our, you know, weaknesses and our wounds, but, you know, we always need to find comfort and strength in the Word of God. When I was preparing this meditation, actually, you know, came across this sentence in the book of Jeremiah, because at this place, in the daily readings, not mass, we were reading Jeremiah. And, you know, I don't know if you're familiar with this story, but Jeremiah was probably one of the prophets, poor thing. He really had a, you know, very difficult life. God really had a very difficult mission. You know, he wasn't understood, he wasn't believed, you know, he was foretelling the exile, and people wouldn't, you know, believe him. They put him into prison, and, you know, all sorts of things. And so, in the midst of all these, you know, hardships that Jeremiah had to go through, this is the word that he received from God. I have made you a fortified city, a pillar of iron, a wall of brass. Now, I love the Bible, because the Bible, sometimes when we talk, we tend to be very, you know, abstract, but the Bible is not abstract at all. It always gives us images. Now, just think of these images. You know, when I stop meditating on these images, I was so consoled, and a fortified city. First of all, it speaks about a city. You're like a city. You're not like a little village or a little hut, you know, or a small house. You're like a city, and it's fortified. You know, so it's strong. You are a pillar of iron. So I was thinking of a pillar of iron. Have I ever seen a pillar of iron? I mean, I don't know if I'm wrong, I see a lot of pillars, not a house, and they've been there for more than 2,000 years, so, you know, they're really strong, but they're really slow. So I'm thinking, can you imagine a pillar of iron? That would be strong, you know? A wall of brass. Majestic, you know? And God is not telling Jeremiah, you know, I think I'm going to make you a pillar of iron. No, he said, I have made you a fortified city, a pillar of iron. So God is telling us, each one of us today, don't worry, don't be afraid. You are strong. You are very strong. And you're strong with me. And I have actually a funny story about it. You probably heard this story already because your sisters sometimes we tell it. It's a story of this, you know, little kid that was trying to move a very, very heavy base, and he was pushing on his friend, and he couldn't move it, not even half an inch. And his father was looking at him, smiling, and, you know, at a certain point, he asked the child, he said, have you put on your strength? And, you know, pushing the base, and the child said, oh, yes, daddy, I put everything, all my strength. And the father's mother said, no, you did it. He said, oh, I did, I put all my strength. And the father said, you didn't? You didn't put mine. You didn't ask for mine, for my strength. So God's strength is our strength. We work together, we have an ally, we are there together with God. In this endeavor of, you know, facing and achieving freedom. Because at the end, it's really a work of freedom, to be free from, you know, the compulsion of reacting in our pain. And